Hi, I am Dr. Saqib Mansoor, and today I will discuss with you the gamekeeper's thumb or the skier's thumb. So it is a hyperabduction injury of the thumb. Here it is a hyperabduction, and the ulnar collateral ligament gets torn. So let's discuss in detail one of the ligament injuries involving the ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb, metacarpophalangeal joint. Definition: skier's thumb or gamekeeper's thumb is an acute partial or the complete rupture of the ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb, metacarpophalangeal joint, due to hyperabduction trauma of the thumb. A ligament is a fibrous connective tissue which attaches a bone to another bone. So the definition of the ligament: the ulnar collateral ligament attaches metacarpal bone at the base of the thumb with the proximal phalanx of the thumb. Here you could see this is the torn or ruptured ulnar collateral ligament. Here you could see this is the ligament attaching the two bones. This is the first phalanx, and this is the metacarpal. And this is another beautiful picture of the torn ulnar collateral ligament. Here you could see this is the torn ulnar collateral ligament. And here you could see adductor pollicis muscle and aponeurosis that is involved in it. We'll discuss it very soon. What's the cause of the skier's thumb? The injury occurs when one falls on the outstretched thumb and is more likely to take place if the thumb grips something simultaneously. Falling during skiing while holding a ski pole is a usual cause, hence the name commonly given to the injury. Though the other causes in other sports injury can cause it as well. I will mention it in coming time. Though both terms are frequently used interchangeably, but there's a difference. Skier's thumb is an acute injury of the thumb. And the gamekeeper's thumb specially refers to cause being related with a chronic injury to the ulnar collateral ligament where it became weakened through repetitive stress. What is the mechanism of injury? Injury to the ulnar collateral ligament. This injury occurs in skiers who fall onto extended thumb, forcing it into hyperabduction. A small fragment of bone can be pulled off simultaneously. Subsequent loss of stability can hamper significantly with grasping activities or the pinch. It is important to note that this injury is not exclusive to skiers and can occur to anyone when there is an extreme valgus stress force applied to the thumb in abduction and extension or small repetitive valgus stress force. So there is the valgus stress force means an hyperabduction. This type of injury is also seen in other sports, especially those that use a stick or ball such as hockey or basketball. It is called skier's thumb but can also occur in football, handball, basketball, rugby, soccer, and even a handshake. So, ulnar collateral ligament gets inserted partially into the palmar plate. In a partial rupture, only ligament proper gets torn and thumb is unstable in the flexion but still more or less stable in the full extension because palmar plate is intact. In a complete rupture, both ligament proper and the palmar plate get torn and the thumb is unstable in all positions. In case the ligament ruptures fully, typically at its distal attachment to the base of the proximal phalanx, it does not heal if it is not repaired. This is for the reason that proximal end is trapped in front of adductor pollicis aponeurosis, and this is the Stanner lien. We'll show you the picture of adductor pollicis longus, adductor pollicis muscle. Here you could see this. This is the adductor pollicis. It has two heads, the transverse head, here it is, and this is the oblique head. This is the adductor pollicis. The aponeurosis is involved. Stanner lien. When the adductor pollicis aponeurosis falls under the torn ulnar collateral ligament, generating a palpable mass or bump. Let's very important thumb instability test or the thumb stress test. Here you could see this. This is being performed in the hand by the doctor. Stress test for the torn ulnar collateral ligament of the thumb, skier's thumb. The thumb ulnar collateral ligament stress test, also called a valgus stress test, is a procedure that a doctor carries out to check stability of the thumb and decide if ulnar collateral ligament is torn. So, how the test is performed? The doctor stabilizes the thumb's metacarpal bone with one hand. This is being stabilized. This metacarpal bone is being stabilized by one hand of the doctor, and he pushes thumb metacarpophalangeal joint into radial deviation, the valgus stress, while holding metacarpophalangeal joint flexed to about 30 degree. He repeats test in extended position, right? Thumb instability test. When it is said to be positive sign, a positive test points towards a possible ulnar collateral ligament injury if there is substantial laxity or instability in metacarpophalangeal joint compared to unaffected side, particularly when thumb is bent at a certain angle. So the stability factors. The passive stability is provided by the following structures: the proper collateral ligament, accessory collateral ligament, dorsal capsule, and the volar plate. And the dynamic stabilizer to valgus stress are following. They consist of the intrinsic and extrinsic muscles of the thumb, extensor pollicis brevis, extensor pollicis longus, adductor pollicis, flexor pollicis brevis, and the flexor pollicis longus. Here you could see various muscles of the there. This is the adductor pollicis, flexor pollicis brevis, and flexor pollicis longus. The ligaments. The two main supporting ligaments traversing the metacarpophalangeal joint of the thumb, the ulnar collateral and the radial collateral ligaments, the two ligaments. The ulnar collateral and the radial collateral ligaments take origin from the medial and lateral tubercle of the metacarpal condyle and get inserted into the base of the proximal phalanx on their respective sides underneath the adductor bone rosace. The ulnar collateral ligament stops thumb from pointing too far away from the hand. So the clinical assessment. On examination, there is swelling and tenderness exactly over ulnar side of the thumb metacarpophalangeal joint. An X-ray is indispensable to rule out a fracture before performing any stress test. Laxity is often apparent, but if there is doubt, the joint may be examined under a local anesthetic. If there exists no excessive laxity compared with the normal side in both extension and 30 degrees of the flexion, then a grave injury may be excluded or ruled out. If there is more than a small number of degrees of laxity, there is perhaps a complete rupture which requires surgical repair. So, what's the symptoms of the rupture? Symptoms can occur minutes to hours after fall that resulted in injury. Symptoms are pain at the base of the thumb in the first web space between the thumb and the index finger, swelling of the thumb, inability to grip or weakness of the grasp between thumb and index finger, tenderness to touch along the ulnar side of the thumb, and discoloration, blue or black, of skin over thumb. Thumb pain that aggravates with movement in one or more directions, pain in wrist that can be referred pain from the thumb. So, what are the grades of the thumb sprains? Sprains of the thumb are graded by the degree of the ligament is pulled or torn. Intermediate classification is used for this. These are the five types of injuries. Type 1, the fracture is undisplaced and on examination it is stable in flexion less than 30 degree. Number 2, fracture is displaced, no distinctive test. Number 3, fracture is absent, stability in flexion less than 30 degree. And number 4, there is no fracture, not stable in flexion greater than 30 degree. And avulsion fracture of the volar plate is the number 5. This examination stable in flexion. What is the DD or the differential diagnosis? The damage can extend to other structures like bony structures, tendons, adductor bone rosace, accessory collateral ligament, and neurological tissues. These all injuries present with weakness of pincer grasp. Nevertheless, they can be differentiated by location of tenderness. So, first of all, is the Stanard lesion. It's a particular type of ulnar collateral ligament injury with palmar subluxation of the base of the proximal phalanx. A Stanard lesion has been described and the stress test as well with a picture. Bennett or Ronaldo fracture and intra-articular fracture luxation at base of the first metacarpal in the carpometacarpal joint. And then is the it has to be differentiated from the avulsion fracture in children who have an immature skeleton still. The hyperabduction trauma frequently results in a Salter-Harris type 3 avulsion of ulnar collateral ligament insertion and infrequently to a true rupture of the ulnar collateral ligament. So differential diagnosis continues. The wrist sprain. In a wrist sprain injury, the ligaments of wrist get stretched further than their normal limits. Dislocation of the first metacarpophalangeal joint also to be differentiated from the wrist fracture, chronic instability of the first metacarpophalangeal joint, injuries to two main supporting ligaments, traveling metacarpophalangeal joint of thumb may result in symptomatic joint instability with a consequent weakness, pain, and arthritis if overlooked. These two ligaments are ulnar and radial collateral ligaments. I've already discussed with you the main two ligaments. So other diseases from which it is to be differentiated is the osteoarthritis of the rheumatoid arthritis and also from the lunate dislocation. And in the last, this ulnar collateral ligament rupture has to be differentiated from the neuropraxy of the radial nerve that arises secondary to swelling, traction, or stiffness. So what are the outcome measures? Stability of metacarpophalangeal joint as measured by stress testing as used in examination. What could be the complications of the disease, of the tear of the ulnar collateral ligament? If the ulnar collateral ligament gets ruptured, the possibility is that the distal end can get interposed by adductor aponeurosis, so which is referred to as a Stanner lesion, as discussed in detail previously. Stanner lesion is hard to diagnose, but it results in poor healing and commonly indicates operative treatment. If not treated, a torn ulnar collateral ligament may result in joint instability and a feeble pinch grip. So what are the diagnostic procedures? How to diagnose the ulnar collateral ligament tear? So type of lesion can be precisely derived by use of X-ray, ultrasound, or MRI X-rays. The anteroposterior and lateral X-ray films of the thumb are carried out to exclude any accompanying bony injuries. Accompanying bony avulsion fractures are observed in 20% to 30% of the rupture of the ulnar collateral ligament. The position of an avulsed bony fragment commonly points to position of the distal end of the ulnar collateral ligament. So the indications for surgery based on imaging comprise avulsion fractures with displacement of larger than 5 mm or a fracture that involves 25% or greater of metacarpophalangeal joint surface. Stress X-ray films of the thumb metacarpophalangeal joint have been used too for the diagnosis. Here you could see this is the X-ray of this tear of the ligament. This is a bony, fragment. Ultrasound is an outstanding and cost-effective method for the diagnosis of the tear, for the reason that it permits direct visualization of entire ulnar collateral ligament and the surrounding structures. It can locate torn end of the ulnar collateral ligament in about 90% of the cases. MRI is a gold standard method, having a sensitivity of 96% to 100% and a great specificity of 95 to 100% MRI. So the diagnostic procedures continue. The arthrography, it consists of distension of the metacarpophalangeal joint by injecting a contrast material and afterwards visualizing the joint with X-ray or MRI. So these are what is a treatment. The partial tears may be treated by immobilization with the splint for a short period, 2 to 4 weeks, followed by increasing movement. Partial tears may be treated by a short period, 2 to 4 weeks again, of immobilization in a splint followed by the increasing movement. Pinches to be avoided for 6 to 8 weeks. Complete tears require surgery. Care must be observed during exposure not to injure superficial radial nerve branches. Stanner lesion is present at the proximal edge of the adductor aponeurosis. The aponeurosis is cut and redirected to expose ligaments and the capsule and the torn structure are carefully repaired afterwards. So the treatment continues and the post-operative management. Joint is to be immobilized in a thumb splint for a period of 6 weeks, but may be moved early in a flexion extension plane due to the fact that the ligament is isometric, that its length is same in flexion and extension. The interphalangeal joint of thumb must be left free from the start to prevent adductor aponeurosis becoming adherent that will limit flexion. A neglected tear causes weakness of the pinch. In early cases where there is no articular damage, stability can be restored by the use of a free tendon graft if this doesn't work or if the joint gets painful. Metacarpophalangeal joint arthrodesis is dependable and leaves negligible functional deficit. In the children, injury can coexist with a Salter Harris type 3 fracture through the physis is to be reduced and fixed with smooth K wires, which must not cross the growth plate. Exercise therapy in the last, and as the period of immobilization gets completed, therapy should be taking place. Mostly the patient performs exercises to help strengthen and stretch the joint to regain full function in the thumb. The patient may begin supervised hand therapy during period of immobilization. Mild flexion and extension range of motion exercises may start after about 1 month, with the patient continuing to wear splint between the therapy sessions. So after 1 month, advanced strengthening exercises can be started, but unlimited activity is not allowed until after 3 months. Pinching and gripping actions must not begin until 3 months and must be progressive as they are tolerated. Forceful gripping actions are characteristically not tolerated until about week 12. So thank you very much for watching my video. So now there are a lot many on the hand clinicals, the finger deformities and much more. So do support my channel and subscribe. Goodbye.